exclusive presentation of Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports.
Maryland fans get their guard up when the Terrapins hit the road. Veteran Mike Jones whips the Terps from the perimeter. His 48 threes, third best in the ACC. Virginia can counter with J.R. Reynolds from the outside and Sean Singletary attacking the inside. They're the ACC's most dangerous backcourt pair. Welcome to the brand new John Paul Jones Arena in Charlottesville, Virginia. As Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports bring you ACC basketball, the Virginia Cavaliers host the Maryland Terrapins. The students are back for spring semester at Virginia, and all 15,219 seats are spoken for, and they'll be in full throat as we continue our 25th year of bringing you ACC basketball with Maryland at Virginia, and it's coming your way next.
What's going on, Sanchez?
It's Nelson. He's pruning.
Oh, come on. The game's on.
Get him out of there.
Welcome to the Bud Light Bunker, Nelson.
What do you guys do down here?
Nothing.
Sweet.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
We got a bogey.
Get him out of there.
Want the candy? You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school. Vader! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Man, I said this to everybody.
Hey.
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
The dream is still alive. Like me and you, so let the voice of freedom sing out through this land. This is our country.
This is our truck. The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year, the all-new Chevy Silverado.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Pepsi, by Alltel, by Food Lion, by Geico, by Ford, by Chick-fil-A, by Advance Auto Parts, and by Bud Light.
Welcome back to Charlottesville, Virginia. Steve Martin here, along with Dan Bonner, and all the excitement of ACC basketball. But really what we've got is two teams that need upward traction in the ACC early.
Maryland trying to build on that big win against Clemson after a tough loss to Miami, and Virginia's lost three in a row. They can't afford to get any further down in the conference.
Well, Dan, let's take a look at our Food Lion starting lineups. And right now for the Maryland Terrapins, the big man, Kenny Ibikwe, against Saturday, a double-double against Clemson. Gravis Vasquez, DJ Strawberry, Mike Jones, James Giss, the starting lineup for Gary Williams, Maryland Terrapins. For the Virginia Cavaliers at 9-6, J.R. Reynolds has been hot lately, 20 points at Boston College in a loss there by 5 points, paired with Sean Singletary in the backcourt. Larinas Michalauskas, Mamadi Diani, and Jason Kane for Dave Leto and the Cavaliers, who are at 9-6. Both of these teams 1-2 in ACC play. As John Singletary looks to get the Cavaliers going, you look at James Gist, and there's J.R. Reynolds. Many people think that if you get into those guards, Dan, you can really slow down Virginia. We'll see if that's right.
Both of these teams like to play an up-tempo style, so I don't expect that we'll have a 50-49 affair tonight.
Here's DJ Strawberry looking for the game's first basket. Diani boards the miss.
Man-to-man defense for Maryland.
Kane started the last three ball games.
Strawberry matched up against Sean Singletary.
Kane moves inside of Beckway and scores. First basket of the game belongs to Virginia.
Virginia's got to get some contributions from their guys on the inside, so that's a positive sign for the Cavaliers.
Singletary takes it right out of the Beckway's hands, and he'll run the three-on-one break. Diani Kuma. Vasquez up court. Here's Strawberry with two Cavaliers there. Count the basket, plus the foul. And as they go to the line, let's take a look at our four keys to the game, Dan, especially here for the Maryland Terrapins. Perimeter playmaker.
Well, you just saw one of the perimeter playmakers, DJ Strawberry. They've got to make plays on offense. They've got to make plays on defense from the Maryland perimeter. And I just said, Virginia has got to get some significant contributions from their inside guys. They generally do a good job defensively, but I think they have to contribute some offense tonight.
Well, Michalauskas and Kane have to get it going. Diani's had a pretty hot hand for them. Strawberry with a three-point play puts Maryland on the board here.
And here comes Maryland with the pressure.
Virginia breaks it. Diani on his way, and it's a blocking foul. We look at Gary Williams, of course, in his 18th season. 368 wins. Of course, coming back at his alma mater and winning a national championship. And there's Dave Leto in his second season here at Virginia. That was going to be on Gist. That's his first, team's first, and Amadi Diani on the free throw line. Diani's improvement has been really tangible in his field goal percentage, going from 33% to 48%.
And overall, you're right, Steve. However, Diani has really been up and down. When he's on, the Virginia Cavaliers have an effective third option from the perimeter, and they've become very, very good.
Diani boards the miss off his second. Mike Wood trying to dig it out. Mike Jones up. Here's Kane. Michalauskas now handling down the lane, and he'll go to Diani for the score.
Virginia just a little bit quicker to the loose balls. I think Maryland thought they had that one. They're headed down the court. So a break for the Cavaliers if they can get it back.
Vasquez ahead. Beckway at the top. Virginia and a man as well. Strawberry fouled before he made his move, says Tim Nestor.
Now, this is going to be a very interesting ball game in terms of the fact that each of these teams, I said, likes to run. So that time Virginia was able to set their defense, make Maryland play in the half court. And Dave Leto knows that Maryland, not really a great three-point shooting team, really like to keep them in front of you.
Here's Mike Jones, probably the exception to that rule, and he misses his first offer.
The Terrapins shoot a very high percentage from three.
Singletary inside. Kane working hard. Won't get the basket, but he'll go to the foul line. And the foul's going to be on DJ Strawberry.
It's the kind of contribution we're talking about. Jason Kane lost his starting job for a couple of years and now has it back. Kane has always been a very effective offensive rebounder. And what creates the offensive rebound opportunity? In this case, the passing opportunity in the inside play. Well, it's that penetration from Sean Singletary. You saw him draw three guys and then find the open man.
Singletary and Reynolds will be the guys who will try to dish it in the inside, and they can do some damage outside as well. Kane has had really two seasons, the first six versus the last eight. The first six, he was averaging 9 points a game. The last eight, 6 points a game. Back in the starting lineup, making one for two.
He has also been very inconsistent in his playing time, has gone down as a result.
Inside of Beckway, lost the ball on the end line with Kane playing defense.
Boy, Maryland on the offensive end really trying hard to get inside that Virginia defense off the dribble. And unless that's accompanied by some ball and player movement, it's a hard thing to do.
They did it a lot against Clemson. You know, the win over the Tigers. Kidding from the outside has five early. Virginia up by five over Maryland. That's James Gist.
That's a tough move right there.
Yes, it is. Here comes Singletary, first three of the game for either side. Sean Singletary, and Virginia stays up by six.
Strawberry just lost it. Virginia gets the ball inbounds very quickly, and Strawberry is chasing him. It's hard to guard Sean Singletary when you're looking at the back of his uniform. If you can read his name, you're in the wrong place.
You're in trouble. You're what they call a trailer. The foul is going to be on Jason Kane inside. It is the second team foul on Virginia. Here's Jones from the corner. He's deadly for three. That's 49 three-pointers against all competition this season. 11-8, Virginia. Still on the man. J.R. Reynolds.
That's a tough matchup for Vasquez, trying to guard J.R. Reynolds. Big challenge for the freshman.
From the top scores, third active score in ACC history right now. And here's his first offering of the night.
Not a lot more he can do in that situation. That was a great offensive move.
Used a hard dribble to rub off the defender and finish with the rest. He's got a 5-point lead, Virginia, now over a team that has beaten him six straight times. But the last two here in Charlottesville, both at U-Haul, have been decided on the last possession. Vasquez up top to Strawberry.
In each of the two games they played last year, one of the teams ran out to a big lead and the other team rallied.
Vasquez stripped to the ball inside by Singletary. Here comes Reynolds. Reynolds on his way.
Oh,
what a play by Hemingway. Wow. Those two cancel each other out. Vasquez for three. Here's Reynolds.
So a nice block out in the transition by Mikolauskas. That is a long shot.
Reynolds saw what happened last play. The last guy that went in deep. Jason Kane can't make it work with defense by Vasquez. Here comes Mike Jones. Short distance this time. And this is the type of tempo that Virginia likes to play, that Maryland likes to play at.
And Virginia doesn't mind playing this tempo either. So it's very important for each squad to get back on defense.
Singletary. Reynolds with a clean look. And Beckway pulls away the ball. Beckway at 7.5 rebounds, leading rebounder for the Terrapins. Here's Gist. Too much spin on the hook. Kane boards the miss. Here comes Singletary. And a collision with a Beckway, it appears. Beckway picks up his first. Mike Jones on the fast break basket for the Terrapins. It's end-to-end action, and Virginia leads Maryland by three. Students are back, and they're having a good time at Virginia. Virginia leading Maryland 13-10. And there's a man who's been instrumental in a lot of those. He's won a lot of those for the Maryland Terrapins. Their head coach, 1969 and 1986. Maryland has won this series 101 times, and many of them under the guidance of Lefty Brazil.
One of the great coaches and great personalities in the history of the Atlantic Coast Conference.
Probably one of the biggest thrills was watching Maryland win the 84 ACC championship, which was Lefty's first. Singletary on the free throw line. Virginia 3-for-5 from the stripe right now. They lead by four. Singletary now with 5 points. Cavaliers up by that margin over their border rivals from Maryland.
One of the important things for Maryland is to keep Singletary off the free throw line.
E.J. Strawberry can make it work inside. Gist travels as he picked up the rebound and put the stick back in.
Maryland has been able to get close to the basket, but a little bit of frustration for him early. Sean Singletary made those two free throws. That's twice as many free throws as he attempted in his last two games combined.
Virginia outshot on the road, I think something like 61-18 on the free throw. There's the turnover story. Gianni goes in and challenges. The basket will count. Bombali Osby picks up the foul. Gianni with 5 points already.
Virginia thus far doing a nice job moving the basketball. Guys moving without the ball moving pretty well. That time after a couple of passes, Gianni able to get down the lane.
Gianni on the line with a three-point play. That puts Virginia up by its biggest margin, 9. They took a 9-0 lead on Boston College at the start of that game in D.C. on Saturday. The up and under by Osby counts plus the foul.
And Dave Lato up telling the officials that he thinks Osby walked on the play.
Tunji Soroye picks up the foul for Virginia. He came in just a moment ago to replace a tired Jason King.
The pace of the game means that you'll see a lot of substitutions, particularly by Virginia's big guys. I thought Mikolauskas was laboring getting up and down the floor. So that is why Tucker and Soroye are in the game now.
Jones and Gist come out. Hayes comes in. And Ibekwe comes back off the bench as Osby goes to the line.
Hayes and Vasquez, for the most part, have shared the point guard duty for Maryland this year, but they certainly can play together, and next year you'll see a lot of them playing together. That'll be the Maryland strategy.
Strawberry penetrates. Here's the shot. Adrian Joseph from the corner. He's just come in. Ibekwe wrestles loose the rebound. Hayes pushes it ahead. In the post, it goes to Osby.
Well, he did a great job running to the block, getting position, and it's almost impossible to guard a big guy in the block if he's going to run that way, because he gets set up where any help can
come. He's coming his way to Maryland from New Mexico and Paris Junior College in Texas. And especially his back to the basket.
He's from Richmond.
Yeah.
They took the long route to College Park. Maryland stays in the man-to-man.
Singleton measures it from outside. Shot clock down to 10. Here's Jamil Tucker. And he hits the three. Tucker, the second triple for the Cavaliers. 21-14 Virginia. Strawberry. Kick out Vasquez. Here's Hayes for three.
I think Tucker may have gotten a hand on that one. That was excellent defense by Virginia.
Singletary pushes. Jamil Tucker tries it again. Tucker, a pair of hits from three-point line, and Gary Williams wants a timeout.
Maryland cannot allow Sean Singletary to run in transition like that. You've got to stop the ball.
We'll return after this message from the University of Virginia. First half, Virginia has shot out on a pair of Jamil Tucker three-pointers to a 10-point lead. Maryland with the ball. Osby inside, threw it away.
The Virginia defense thus far has been outstanding. Maryland not really able to run anything on offense. That's Solomon Tatt with a traveling violation.
Tatt, a true freshman out of Nigeria. Makes the travel violation. He's been out 10 games with a groin injury.
Last year, the University of Virginia ran out to a 14-point lead up in College Park, and Maryland eventually came back and won the game. Virginia rallied from an 18-point deficit in the game in Charlottesville and nearly won the game.
So Mike Jones hit a three for the final minute of the play. Loose underneath, Maryland picks it up and finishing inside Akinne Ibekwe. He paid for it, but he finished.
That's great hustle by Ibekwe. I think he was upset with himself that he missed that first shot. He had some defensive pressure from Tucker. But Ibekwe's got a few inches on Tucker. If he's that close to the basket, he's got to take that pressure and score. And he did not. And I think he really did a nice job getting after the ball and recovering.
Ibekwe, last four, 14 and a half points and 8 rebounds. And 17 of 28 from the field. He misses the three-point play opportunity, and Virginia comes away with a rebound. He is up by 8. This is Tatt.
Sean Singletary on the bench taking a little bit of a break. breather for the Cavaliers. He won't be out long.
Not. About 16 points to the
end. Nice pass. Reynolds to Kane. Boy, everybody at the rim. And picking it off is Tad on the outlet from the back row. Tad inside. Offensive foul. Manny Beckway has spent a good measure of this first half on his back.
He has, and that was a pretty good recovery by Beckway. He tried to make the tough outlet pass, and it was tipped by Tucker. Tad intercepted, and nice job by Beckway. He blocked the last shot, and I think Tad thought he was going to go after that one. So Tad went very strongly to the goal, and Beckway held his ground.
Second Maryland turnover, 16 foul on the Virginia Cavaliers, who lead this by 8. Jones has the baseline, has a cutter, and Bowers, and a foul coming up against Virginia. Timeout on the court with Virginia leading Maryland 24-16 in Charlottesville.
Choosing to enroll at the University of Virginia was one of the best decisions I've ever made. There's something magical about this university that touches people from all kinds of diverse backgrounds. Whether it's the natural beauty, the architecture, the history, or just the fact that you're working together with people who are passionate, dedicated, smart, you begin to understand that Virginia is more than just a school. It's really a national treasure.
It's Virginia 24, Maryland 16. Virginia trying to snap a six-game losing streak at the hands of the Terrapins. From the field, both of these teams are hitting pretty well early on.
See, Sean Singletary, he is the big key. You know, we were talking about his free throw shooting in the three-game stretch, American, Gonzaga, and Stanford. He was 31 of 34 from the line. And then in the next two games, North Carolina and Boston College, they combined 1 for 1. So he needs to get to the line. Bowers at the line makes the first one.
Maryland shooting all over 100 more free throw attempts in their opposition. They buried Clemson on the line Saturday, 25-5. And now Bowers hits a pair, and that trims the Virginia lead to 6.
See, Maryland's backed off on their pressure a little bit. I think Virginia's a very difficult team to pressure.
And really because of that guy. Singletary changed direction on Strawberry and induced the foul. That's the second foul on Strawberry.
As Singletary just told it.
Yeah.
Strawberry had something to say to Singletary, and Singletary just held up his two fingers and says, that's two fouls, buddy.
And he's headed to the bench, and Vasquez replaced him.
Well, now this becomes even more interesting. We talked about Maryland's perimeter and the importance of their perimeter players making plays, and now they've got two freshmen who are going to have to make those plays, Hayes and Vasquez. And here's Hayes matched up against Sean Singletary.
You look quickly at Hayes, you see Steve Blake. Joseph at the top of the floor.
And he's going to have to give Singletary some room, and Singletary can be a very dangerous three-point shooter when you do that.
There's the three from the ring. Pretty well defended. Kane couldn't bring down the rebound. There's Eric Hayes from Dumfries, Virginia. Played for his father, Kendall. High school. We look real quick.
Well, they really think, the folks in Maryland really think that, you know, he gets some experience in the program, gets in the weight room a little bit. He's going to be an outstanding player.
Bowers' shot doesn't work. Kane falls down, so it's a 4-on-5. Reynolds' shot blocked, but there's a foul. Foul, I believe, is going to be on Gravis Vasquez. Join the mania, ACC fans. You can win up to $100,000 plus hundreds of other great prizes to enter Alltel's My Circle Mania sweepstakes. Text OOPS to 84353 or visit MyCircleMania.com. I'm a million thumbs with text messages. Takes me an hour to print out okay.
Just call up somebody. Call them up. They're in the text message. Virginia 6 of 8 now from the free throw line. One of the problems for the University of Maryland, if they go down on the offensive end and shoot the ball quickly, before Virginia's defense has had to move around, Virginia an excellent position for rebounding, which means they're an excellent position for a fast break opportunity. And Virginia has used those opportunities very effectively today.
J.R. Reynolds, 76% free throw shooter, tans a pair, and pushes Virginia's lead to 8 again, and as big as 10. Vasquez to Hayes, open for a 3. Bowers can't hang on to the rebound. Here comes Reynolds. Pass Jones and a foul on Mike Jones.
That's going to be his first.
Both teams with 17 fouls. This broadcast is a copyrighted presentation. Any use of it without the express permission of Raycom, Lincoln Financial Sports, and the ACC is prohibited. Welcome you to the brand spanking new John Paul Jones Arena.
And now Virginia in the bonus already. 10 minutes, 46 seconds left in the half. Virginia will be shooting at least a 1-1 from here out.
Well, both teams will at this point. And this is what the players affectionately call the JPJ. 15,291, and they're all filled, and the students are back. They start school tomorrow. Reynolds hangs on, but Virginia gets the rebound. Nikolaskis playing big inside. Here's Reynolds. And this time the Betway pulls it down for Maryland. Vasquez in the front court. Near the midway point of this first half, Maryland trailing by nine. Vasquez out of the post up on Reynolds. Ibekwe lifts.
See, that was a little bit backwards. Vasquez playing inside, passing it out to Ibekwe. Maybe the other way around would work better.
Or maybe if he found Mike Jones. Ibekwe treated it as a foreign object out that deep.
And Gary Williams, I think, is of the opinion that Ibekwe ought to treat it as a foreign object. The operative advice that he would give it Beckway is get closer.
Exactly. Both teams have missed their last three field goal attempts since that last time out.
But Virginia's been able to get to the free throw line and convert. And so maintaining their lead.
Well, it speaks to what the point that you made in one of the four keys, and that is an interior presence. And Virginia's been able to exhibit that. Here's another example. Nikolaskis. All five Virginia starters in the group now, and they have their biggest lead.
Virginia can get some contributions offensively from those inside guys. They become that much more effective because they have outstanding perimeter players.
Arenas Nikolaskis with the big play, so we have a timeout on the floor. And as the teams discuss strategy, you should too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck, Charles Schwab. What's Dave Lato saying to his team right now?
Well, Dave Lato is preaching defense right at the moment to the Virginia Cavaliers. His theory has always been that the better you play on defense, that will improve your offense. And so he likes what the Cavaliers are doing on the offensive end, but he wants them to maintain their defensive intensity because that's why they've gotten themselves to this 11-point lead.
Well, right now they've got them somewhat unsettled with their defense. And it's been a straight man-to-man for the most part, but they've helped out inside when the ball's gone up. Hayes to the baseline. This is Osby inside, first time denied. Nikolaskis in there.
That was a nice move, but you really have to finish that play.
A beautiful pass by Reynolds. Kane pays it off, but he travels. Take away the basket by Jason Kane. What a pass by J.R. Reynolds.
That was a great, great pass in traffic. I don't know how Reynolds saw him over there. Nobody really came to help. There wasn't a double team against Reynolds. Osby just lost sight of his man.
And here's Giss scoring inside. He's got four. That's the first Maryland field goal in almost 3 minutes. They're down by nine. Deani makes his move. And he's fouled inside. It looks like it's going to be on Osby.
It's Mike Jones, and that's two fouls, I think, on Mike Jones. Strawberry already on the bench with two. So Maryland going to have to go a lot deeper than maybe they'd want to this early in the first half.
This will bring Parrish Brown off the bench as Deani will go up. And he's up for two this time. That is the eighth team foul on Maryland. Coming up on Saturday, more ACC basketball from Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports. And what a showdown. Boston College. Looking strong early on, and what about Clemson? Suffering only their first loss in 18 games at the hands of Clemson. Amadi Diani with 8 points. Virginia up 31-20.
And that's the recipe for success for the Cavaliers. Diani having a good offensive output. Parrish Brown misses, but the inside guys having a good offensive output. Sean Singletary able to get out and run.
He's got Diani on the baseline, and Diani's got trouble. Gets out of it to Kane for three. Lost out of bounds by Virginia. It's going to be Maryland ball. And as foreign as the ball is to Obetwe beyond the three-point arc, it's equally so to Jason King at 1-for-6 from three-point arc.
Maryland really needs to get something going on the offensive end.
And now Virginia slips back into his zone. Gets the just. Can't get the reverse to go. Here's Deani. Singletary lifts a three over Terrace.
That's what you call a deep, deep three. Good heavens, and that was a guy in his face.
8 points for Singletary. Virginia's up by 14. Hayes drops it in. Here's Gifts to Brown. They can't seem to get that third pass going. Here's Osby.
You see, they get the ball inside. They miss the shot. That allows Virginia to get out in transition.
And here's a foul coming up.
And this is where, that's where Virginia's been most effective. They have prevented Gary Williams' crew from getting into the transition offense, and they have been executing their transition offense perfectly. Missed the shot now as Singletary, as Reynolds pushes it, Virginia with an advantage. And Reynolds takes advantage, drawing the foul.
Vasquez comes out. Strawberry's back in, playing with two fouls. Reynolds on the free throw line, where he's 3-for-4 today. And he's even in the point and rebound department, as you see. A man from Roanoke, Virginia, in his senior year. Gone for two. Sullivan Tatt comes back in, and Singletary gets a rest at the 8:01 mark.
And 35 points for Virginia with 8 minutes still remaining in the first half is a very impressive offensive output against the Maryland team that's generally outstanding defensively. But as we've said many times before, Steve, it's hard to guard somebody when you're chasing them, and that's what Virginia's been doing most, or Maryland has been doing most of the night, chasing Virginia in transition.
Cavaliers have built a 16-point lead with 8 to play here in the first half. Steve Martin, Dan Bonner here in Charlottesville, and a big noisy crowd out for this quarter war. Osby's pass deflected. And Virginia's done a great job interior defense. Here's Reynolds for two. Hayes is in his face, too. 10 points for J.R. Reynolds. The lead is 18. And it's another timeout for the Maryland Terrapins at the 7:41 mark. Well, you know, ball has been good.
Well, it has been. And Virginia showed in their first half of the game they played against Gonzaga that when they get it going, they can really get it going. Sean Singletary in transition, and Sean Singletary finding J.R. Reynolds. That was Tucker. Again, Tucker. This one is in transition. And here's Singletary, even though Perry's down on it, again in transition. The Maryland defense has not had an opportunity to get set, and it's been because Virginia's really attacking him on the fast break.
Now Virginia 11-22 right now. And you mentioned that Gonzaga came in 18 threes. It's a school record. Sean Singletary now with 8 points. It's 2-for-3 on the floor. That last basket by Reynolds was a two. But it gives Virginia an 18-point lead. And we talked about the guard play of both teams right now. The Virginia guards are playing very, very well. Hayes against the zone. Virginia has really shut off the inside. The baseline jumper won't go. And what a difficult shot by Ikinne Ebekwe. 38-22.
Sometimes your best offense is to throw the ball up there and let one of the big guys go get it.
That was a good shot by Starbury. Unguarded for a change. First field goal in 2+ minutes. Singletary outside of the three.
Ebekwe just doing a great job on the board.
Parrish Brown.
See, that was a shot close to the basket, but he's looking for the foul. And if you don't get it, then suddenly that becomes a very bad play.
Offensive foul on Will Harris as Ebekwe takes the charge. A dangerous take right there. It is Virginia leading Maryland 38-22 with 6:40 left to go in this first half. Our Chick-fil-A nugget of the game. Maryland leads the ACC in field goal defense at 35%. However, Virginia has been allowed to shoot 47%.
Well, I think it's because Maryland has had to play in transition on the defensive end. And I've always thought transition defense was sort of an oxymoron.
We're in transition because we didn't play defense at the other end.
Well, Maryland's problem has been that they have not really been able to get the kind of shots on offense that they normally get. You know, it's funny. Virginia's defense seems to be devoted to forcing Maryland out to the perimeter. This is a Maryland team that scored 92 points against Clemson, but only made 3 3-pointers, only attempted 4.
Right.
So Maryland does most of their damage in transition and inside, and Virginia's been able to cut that off.
Bowers on the free throw, up for 1-1. The foul is charged to Mikolauskas. Mikolauskas has 2. Trouble started to sprout its head on both benches. Amadi Diani with the rebound. Virginia by a comfortable 15 right now. Maryland in the man. Long rest here for Singletary as he breaks it. Here is Reynolds. Ball saved on the inline by Harris, but then no. He stepped out of bounds. There's Tony Green.
Now this is you have to adjust yourself if you're Maryland playing on the defensive end. This is the kind of a game where you cannot put as much pressure on the ball as you normally do. There's Harris stepping out of bounds. You have to back off a little bit because Reynolds and Singletary are both so dangerous with their penetration to the basket. But you have to stay close enough that they don't have an easy three.
Nice steal by Diani as Strawberry got a little careless trying to look at the post.
I don't know that Strawberry ever really had possession of that ball. Nice pass.
Diani for 3. Rebound by Harris in close. Will Harris with the stick back. It's a 17-point Virginia lead.
Perfect opportunity for an offensive rebound. The penetration by Singletary moves the defense. The pass to Reynolds causes the defense to react. Then he makes the extra pass. Nobody in position to rebound.
Rebecca Wade commits his second foul as he hooks Will Harris out of the post up.
Diani shoots that ball. The Maryland defense still trying to react to the rotation. And Harris does a nice job finding the open area.
It's an offensive foul, but it's the 10th team foul against Maryland. Reynolds is 2 for 7, but he's 4 for 5 from the free throw line. 5 for 6, actually, is. Virginia penetrates again, and they draw another foul.
Now Maryland goes to some pressure that time, trying to sort of change things around, and Strawberry went for the steal and missed. And when he does that, Virginia really pushes the ball up the court. They have a man advantage, and the result is a Reynolds penetration and another foul.
Reynolds now with 10 points on the night. Virginia 13 of 16 from the stripe.
And you mentioned that disparity over the last two games.
They already have 2 more free throws than they made against Boston College.
Yeah, outscored from the line 61-18. So
Rounds with 11. They were outscored 35-10 by BC on Saturday. Vasquez. David Vasquez, yeah, he
Now, see, now's the time where the young freshman has to keep his poise. It's a tough environment. You're down by 19 points. Nothing has gone the way you hoped.
Well, Reynolds is fortunate he didn't get called for an offensive foul, but he did step out of bounds with the ball. So good defense by Mike Jones. He didn't induce the foul, but he could induce the turnover.
Very dangerous defensive play, though, by Mike Jones, who has 2 personal fouls.
Exactly. 55 left to go in this first half. It's been all Virginia. Strawberry. Excellent defensive performance by the Cavaliers here early. Just outside the basket is for 3. Adventure tries to tip it in. Here's Singletary. The 3 ball away doesn't go. Ebekwe with a rebound.
That's the only way you can defense that is hope he misses and you get the rebound. That's a heck of a move.
Long shots to get long rebounds. Gis just inside, picks up the loose ball and scores. Maryland scoring on busted plays here, 42-25.
That's a break for Maryland.
A pull up by Singletary.
Now, if you're Singletary, you want to get your team back into the offense again.
Mike Jones for three. Made them pay for the miss. That's his second triple of the night. He's got 8 points, 42-28.
And Dave Leto now barking out to Singletary. Wants him to run some little bit of offense rather than just have Singletary go one-on-one. If he makes the basket, fine. If not, everybody's standing around.
Ooh, we got a foul coming up
on Vasquez, and Singletary has something to say to him.
Vasquez commits the foul. That's his second. Timeout on the court, 3:47 left to play. 25 years of ACC basketball coverage. And we've got the intensity of the Virginia-Maryland battle coming at you from Charlottesville. Virginia like what they see.
42-28. Virginia over Maryland, and a lot of star power in the hall tonight. Cal Ripken Jr., Hall of Fame inductee, of course, watching on. We saw Lefty Griselle earlier. This was a tough ticket to get. The students coming back. Semester beginning tomorrow. And going to the free throw line will be Sean Singletary. Maryland 4 for 7 from the line. Virginia 14 of 17. Singletary has 9 on the night. 43-28. Virginia with a big first half lead. Story while they're getting it done offensively, Dan, has been what they've done defensively.
Absolutely. Their defense has created transition opportunities, and they are just too tough to guard in a transition situation.
Here's a Beckway, and look at the struggles he has to score, but James Gist does. He's got 8.
And here they come again.
Amedee Diani.
And that, Steve, right there's the story of the first half. Maryland kills himself down on the other end. They score a tough basket, and then Virginia gets it in quickly into the hands of Singletary, who creates a shot opportunity for Diani.
One fast break basket for Maryland this first half by Mike Jones, and the rest have been tough. Here's Singletary. Reynolds, and we got a foul on Mike Jones, and that's going to be 3. That's 3 on Jones as he was in compromised position. You know, there's nothing like college basketball, and if you're celebrating and win, do it right. The way you celebrate says a lot about you and reflects on your school, so be responsible. Take care of yourself and your friends. A message from Anheuser-Busch. Reynolds on the free throw line. He now has 12 points. He's now 8 for 9 from the free throw line. Jones has to come out. He'll be done for the first half.
That really hurts Maryland. You're down. You'd like to be able to have a guy who can score from the outside. Jones showed you just a couple of possessions ago. He's very dangerous.
Reynolds with a pair has 13. The other players with 2 fouls from Maryland. Jones with 3.
And Virginia drops back into the zone. Now that Mike Jones, the best 3-point shooter, is out.
Nice steal by Diani. Now he's trying to finish against Hayes. Oh, Jason Hayes! 7 for Kane. 50-30. Virginia in the lead.
Steven, we still have 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. And to see Virginia, you get 6 steals. That generally means you get the transition opportunities.
You know, and Dave Leto, let's look about Jason Kane as he comes to the sideline.
You see the tip by Diani. Kane is all the way on the baseline, but look at him in the background of your picture. Hustling, hustling, hustling. In a transition situation, it's hard to find people to block out, and Kane just goes right to the rim.
And you're raising Kane to get to up 20. Here's Kiss on the low post with the left hand. And it's tipped up and in by Ibekwe.
Credit the basket, 25.
Here's Singletary spinning away from the defense. 50-32. Harris. Diani blows by Kiss, but Ibekwe is there to deny.
And Gary Williams saying that was a double dribble. Saying it loudly.
Tim Nestor's not listening. Strawberry for 3. This place would have come unglued if that had done. Hayes up court quickly. Here's Vasquez. A rare breakout now for the Terrapins. 3 from Strawberry. Singletary. Look at him weave his way into front court. Here's Deani for three. It's almost as if Virginia wants to put a kill shot in now.
And I think that would be a very good idea. They have Maryland reeling. And Dave Lato knows that they just had a couple of really good scoring opportunities. But you're not going to make, well, in that first half against Gonzaga, they did make all their shots. But most of the time, you're not going to make all your shots.
Harris picks up the foul. That puts Strawberry on. Adrian Joseph checks in, and Mamadi Diani goes out.
If you're the Maryland Terrapins, what you are trying to do is simply survive until you can get to the locker room. You're trying to avoid that knockout blow.
Strawberry, front half of the one-on-one, and the ninth team foul.
Gary Williams just anxious to be able to get back into the locker room and regroup a little bit. This has been an extremely impressive Virginia performance.
And both teams have had some great wins and some mysterious losses. Strawberry misses his second. The stick back by Vasquez goes. Davis Vasquez, and then here's the steal. Strawberry on the full court press. Vasquez for three.
Boy, what a big response by Maryland. They were down 20, and just like that, it's 12.
They're looking at the spec, and there's a travel. If you were wondering what Gary Williams is going to say at the half, if I'm a Maryland player, I'd put him in a better frame of mind.
Well, speaking of frames of mind, Dave Lato's frame of mind is he's got to have Sean Singletary back in the game. And so Singletary quickly up off the bench and back in.
Following tack goes out. There's Singletary. Junior from Philadelphia. Minute 12 left to go, first half. Virginia back in that zone. Hayes at the top. Plenty of time. Vasquez for three more.
A couple of big shots by the freshman, and 11-0 Maryland run.
And eight of them from Vasquez.
And they throw it away again.
11-0 run could grow some more. It's a 9-point game. Vasquez.
Oh, what a ship! What a wow!
Oh, Virginia needs a timeout. A 13-0 run. Man, oh, man. The last seven Virginia possessions, two turnovers, and 13 points for Virginia Maryland.
Now Vasquez, as he drives to the basket, take a look at James Gist right there. Nobody blocks him out. Jason Kane turns and looks at the ball. He's got to find Gist and block Gist out.
Gist with a penetration.
Three white shirts around the ball, but Kane, we showed you on that previous replay. The first thing he's got to do is look and find Gist and block him out, then go for the ball. You simply can't turn your back in that situation and try to get the rebound.
Gist, the junior from Silver Spring, Maryland, in double figures, the first Terrapin to do so. He and Gravis Vasquez have brought Maryland back. They were 20 points down, 13 points later, they're just seven back.
You know, it was like Rocky Balboa and Apollo Creed. How does Rocky get up? But Maryland did it.
And now they're in the zone. 22 seconds left to go, 5 second differential in the shot and game clock. Shot clock now to 10.
Well, you got to defend the penetration here.
Harris Brown does that. Kane shut off at the baseline. Three on the shot clock. Deani. No. Kane with a rebound, but a foul. Loose ball foul. Looks like it's going to be on Gist.
And Virginia doing a nice job getting position for that offensive rebound. The Cavaliers have done a great job on the offensive boards tonight, really battling in there.
Virginia going up for free throws 22 and 23.
In the first half.
Yes. They only had something like 19 chances at Boston College, but Kane missed. It's a two-shot foul.
We've had 37 fouls in the first half, and so at 10, you get to shoot two.
Kane comes back for one more. He also is from Philadelphia.
Well, Virginia has been attacking on offense all night long, and when you attack, you generally produce fouls.
That's what they've done to Virginia, to Maryland. Maryland did just that to Clemson on Saturday. He missed them both. Virginia's gone almost 3 minutes without a field goal. Vasquez at the buzzer. No. The first half comes to an end with an interesting conclusion. J.R. Reynolds leads the way with 15 points for the Virginia Cavaliers, but the Cavs have given up 13 unanswered points to Maryland to end the first half, up by only 7 over the Terrapins. ACC basketball is brought to you by RBC Centura, by your Carolina Chrysler dealers, by Sonic Drive-Ins, by Charles Schwab, and by Red Lobster.
Oh, look at that. Maryland grads who work for us.
That's an optimistic assessment.
It is an optimistic assessment. Well, right now, Maryland has right to be optimistic. Dravis Vasquez has 8. James Gist has 10. Together, they combine for 13 points at the finish of the first half. J.R. Reynolds with 13, one of 3 double-figure scorers, joined by Sean Singletary and Mamadi Diani. We're underway in the second half. Steve Martin, Dan Bonner here in Charlottesville. Virginia up by 7. They were up 50-30 before Maryland ran off the last 13 points of the half.
Maryland starts in the zone.
Check some prayers and some foul trouble.
And maybe the zone is the best way to prevent this Virginia penetration that has been so effective all night long.
And Singletary trying to get inside. Drops it to Don Diani.
And maybe not.
12 points for Mamadi Diani.
That's now 6 assists in the game for Sean Singletary. Virginia opens in the man-to-man.
Vasquez. Strawberry catches a screen from Gist. Here's Jones for 3 with Diani in his face.
Jones now 3 of 4 shooting the 3 in the game.
Has 11 points for the night. It's a 6-point Virginia lead. Diani really improved from year 1 to year 2. Plays very well at home, and there is a disparity in his scoring road to home. Somehow 12-8. And a great play by Jones if Vasquez can follow, but he can't.
Well, Chuck Drizel was the guy who caught the ball, and he was open. The problem is he doesn't have a uniform on.
And no eligibility left.
Not Lefty. Lefty didn't catch the ball.
No.
Chuck did.
That's his son.
Chuck Drizel, one of the Maryland assistants.
And play first time.
There he is.
Singletary against the zone. Here's Reynolds. He's covered up by Vasquez. Plays out. Virginia's forays inside. There's one. And it's lost off the hands of Mikolauskas.
One of the things that the zone has accomplished is Virginia isn't in transition all of a sudden. That's now 10 Virginia turnovers. And Virginia throughout the season has been less efficient playing in a strictly half-court setting than in transition.
A whistle and an offensive foul.
And who'd they get?
I think they got Vasquez. Yes, they did. And that's 3 on Vasquez.
And lots of times when those fouls occur, those illegal screening fouls, a big factor is how hard the defense is working to get through the screens. If the defenders are working, they usually get the call.
Singletary in the paint. Mikolauskas trying to pay it off and gets fouled inside. This could be a Vekler. And it's going to be his 3rd. So Vasquez, Ibekwe, and Jones with 3.
Wait, what a great job by Singletary. Draws 2 guys. Gets the ball to Mikolauskas.
More free throws coming for the Cavaliers, who had a bunch of them tonight.
Now, Kane missed 2 right at the end of the first half. And now Mikolauskas misses another one.
Vasquez has to come out. Ibekwe comes out as well. Hayes and Bowers come in now. So key minutes for Maryland while their 2 players in foul trouble sit out for a while.
And Beckway has been a huge factor for the Terrapins tonight.
Four straight free throw misses for Virginia, dating back to the first half. Hayes drops it into Bowers. Strawberry has an open look. And Bowers gets a reach over foul over the top of Mikuláskis. That's two on Bowers. Foul trouble mounts for the Terrapins, not only in team fouls, but individually. Three players with three, Jones, Vasquez, and Beckwith.
And Jones has made three three-point baskets. Vasquez led that offensive spurt at the end of the first half, and Beckway had 11 rebounds and two block shots in the first half.
Singletary stopped by DJ Strawberry, and that's three. Welcome to the club.
Maryland trying to apply some pressure, and the risk you run when you try to apply pressure is if the opponent can beat the pressure, then it's suddenly a transition situation for the opposition. And Virginia's played very well in transition throughout.
Maryland has picked up 14 fouls. Virginia has yet to commit one here in the first 2.5 minutes of the second half. However, the Cavaliers are leaving points on the table. They've missed their last three. DJ Strawberry now joins a group of Maryland players with three fouls.
Steve, remember what we talked about. In the first game these two teams played last year, Maryland overcame a 14-point deficit to win. In the second game, Virginia overcame an 18-point deficit and nearly pulled it out. So I don't know that the big lead meant very much.
Here's Mike Jones. Bowers turns and misses. Rebound, Singleton. For everybody, gets almost four a game.
He's number two on the Cavaliers squad in defensive rebounds at 6 feet tall.
Diani for three. Dominic Diani has 15.
Well, that's a big basket. Maryland had cut that lead to six, and Singletary makes the free throw. Maryland misses, and the big three suddenly is a 10-point game again.
Here's Strawberry. Now Virginia picks up its defensive intensity. Still in the zone. Hayes gets inside. Count the basket and the foul on Mikuláskis, and that is going to be three on him. Eric Hayes, the freshman out of Dumfries, Virginia, went to Potomac High School. And he's on for the three-point play. It may be a battle of who's got the available bodies at the end.
Who brought enough guys?
Yeah. Hayes makes the three-point play, cuts the Virginia lead to seven, and now they'll put up some pressure. This pressure helped him to a 13-0 run at the end of the half. Singletary to Mikuláskis, and great defense by Gist and Bowers. Inside to Gist. For three, it's Eric Hayes, his first three of the game, and Maryland making another run. He's got six. Now it's Virginia that wants timeout. Breaking the action in Charlottesville. 16-14 left in Virginia by four.
Somewhere between starting a business and growing one, you're going to need a bank. We'd like to be it. The small business advisors of RBC Centura. With more proactive advice, proven ideas, and dedicated service than you'd expect.
The Maryland Terrapins rallying in the game, and interestingly enough, using the three-point basket to do it. Mike Jones with his third three-pointer of the game. Eric Hayes, who just knocked down a three-pointer, drives that one to the basket. So Maryland really, they got down by 20, and it's like somebody flipped the switch. They have really done a great job getting back into this.
Maryland puts up the full-court press. Virginia's lead, 120, now chopped to four. Here's J.R. Reynolds attacking. Kane with a rebound. They miss two at close range, and Mike Jones comes up with a miss.
And this two at close range, but they're trying to get it over a 7-foot guy inside. Not always the easiest thing in the world to do.
Here's James Gist. And Gist can't make it work. Bowers. No, wait a second. No basket. It's going to be an over-the-back foul by Will Bowers, which would be his third. Timeout on the point once again with 15:49 left to play. Virginia still up four. ACC basketball is brought to you in part by Q Motor Oil. Steve Martin, Dan Bonner here in Charlottesville, Virginia, where the Virginia Cavaliers are clinging to a four-point lead. Maryland has outscored them 22-6 since there were 3 minutes left to go in that first half. Here's Jason Kane trying to break the Maryland pressure. Maryland's got problems. They get five players with three fouls. Reynolds down the lane. He lost control. Beckley picks it up. Beckley's one of those three players. Inside DJ Strawberry. Here comes an attack by Gist, and he is fouled.
Boy, that was an excellent play by Maryland against the Virginia man-to-man. Maryland runs that flex offense. They've done it for years. They executed it perfectly. And Gist is going to the free throw line, but if you're Gary Williams, you really want your big guy in that situation to dunk the ball in the basket and go to the line to make a three-point play. And now, an easy opportunity. He missed the dunk. Now misses the first free throw.
Solomon Tatt comes in. Singletary gets some rest as Dave Lato tries to find those little holes of rest for Singletary, needing him for the end of this one. Gist for another. Gist now with 11. He's the leading scorer along with Mike Jones for the Terrapins here. And it's a three-point Virginia lead. Tatt breaks the pressure. Jameel Tucker. That's his zone now for Maryland.
Tucker's already made 2 3-point baskets in the game, so Virginia will have to defy him out on the perimeter.
Tucker right there. Nine on the shot clock now. J.R. Reynolds and crashing the boards to Kane, but it's blocked. Goes up again, he's fouled.
And the guilty party standing in there, they all got three fouls, so somebody's going to come out of there with a force.
Looks like it's Mike Jones.
Maryland just not doing a good job of boxing out right there. DJ Strawberry didn't get anybody. In fact, nobody in the zone turned around and blocked anybody out. That's one of the problems you have when you play a zone. The blockout responsibility is not quite as clear.
Trying to find who the foul. It's going to be on DJ Strawberry. And they only say he should have four. So DJ's got four. Kane on the free throw line. Kane now with 8 points. Davis Vasquez comes in. Strawberry comes out with four and half to sit a while.
And as you might expect, with Maryland in all that foul trouble, Virginia has really cashed in at the free throw line. That's really the basis of their lead right at the moment.
19-7 is the play. Second shot by Kane. Also goes in, increases the Virginia lead to five. Eric Hayes running the offense out front for the Terrapins. Inside, it's going to be a Beckway, and he is fouled. Foul coming up on Jason Kane, and that's going to be two. RBC Centura Bank and the ACC have teamed up to recognize elementary and middle school teachers in our communities with a tribute to teachers. 25 special teachers will be selected to win $500 in classroom cash. One grand prize winner gets a $2,000 educational supply shopping spree. Visit rbccentura.com for more details. So Beckway hits the first. He has seven on the night. Maryland now just four games back. 4 points back with 14:36 to play. In all three of their losses, Maryland has shot under 42% from the field. They are now at 42.6. And it's a violation. 10 seconds. Couldn't get across the court. Across the midcourt line. The turnover gives Maryland the ball.
Dave Lato is telling Sean Singletary, you got to go and put yourself in a position where they can throw the ball to you.
That's the turnovers. Maryland, conversely, has 11 games where they've shot 50% or better, and they've won all of them. Gist made a nice pass to Beckway, but he took too many steps. Turnover 13 for the Terrapins. Kane looking for an outlet. 8-point Virginia lead. Here's Reynolds.
Reynolds has stayed in that zone.
Yep. 3 3-pointers for Jamil Tucker.
He just said that they got to find him. A little confusion on the part of Maryland about who's supposed to play that spot down on the wing in the 2-3 zone. By the time they sorted it out, Tucker had an open three. That is a long shot. You got to be kidding.
Solomon Tapp recovers the loose ball, and here comes Virginia. Now up by 6. And Bowman by Jamil Tucker is at it again. That's his first miss in 4 tries. Reynolds. And here's Tapp to keep it alive. The offensive rebounding and the control of the ball by the Virginia Cavaliers. Singletary over Vasquez. Gist boards the miss.
Virginia's shot selection, a little bit questionable.
And a foul on Singletary. A blocking foul that's going to be his first.
You know, Steve, with Virginia building up that big lead, you had the feeling that they shot the ball very well in the first half, but they actually didn't. They only shot 40% from the field.
Hayes, well, they made up the difference, Dan, and they continue to do so as on the foul line. Into the game comes Mamadou Diagne, and Solomon Tapp goes out.
This is a key stretch in the game right here. Maryland has had a couple of opportunities to really draw close, and they haven't been able to make a shot to do it. Now the challenge for the Virginia Cavaliers is to extend that lead while Maryland's in a little bit of a drought.
Maryland defensively, I think, has done a good job on Singletary and Reynolds. They haven't gotten many open looks. In fact, that Singletary shot was his first shot of the second half.
And you could actually say that that wasn't an open look. That was a very difficult shot. Singletary and Reynolds have done a nice job getting to the free throw line. Haven't really shot the ball that well from the perimeter.
Reynolds for 3. Ball locked out of there into a fast break by Vasquez.
Nice job by the Cavaliers getting back on defense.
Virginia 6 of 20 from behind the arc. Vasquez. Offensive foul. Davis Vasquez has 4.
That is a situation that's created because Vasquez is not ready to shoot the ball when he catches it. Hayes makes a nice pass, but he's not ready, so he's got to fake and try to go to the basket. That wasn't a situation where Singletary was so close, Vasquez couldn't get the shot off. Vasquez simply wasn't ready to shoot when he caught the ball.
Harris Brown comes in. Virginia's lead, still 6.
And Maryland squanders another opportunity to draw closer.
In the zone.
Boy, stepped out of bounds. And Virginia, by the same token, squandering some opportunities to stretch the lead out further.
They've been stuck at 61-55 for about a minute and a half. 13 turnovers aside now.
And how many times do you see this, Steve? You've got a wide open offensive first half, and then in the second half, the game really slows down.
Inside, a Beckway seals off team, but can't hit it. Gist to try to among 3 Cavaliers. Got a loose ball foul coming up.
Well, you have to finish that shot.
Virginia hanging on, leading by 6. We'll be right back. Virginia 61, Maryland 55. We've been stuck on that score for almost 3 minutes. And foul trouble emerges again for Maryland. In that last scrum, McKinney Beckway picked up his 4th. He's one of 3 Maryland Terrapins. All starters with 4 fouls. Strawberry and Vasquez, Jones and Bowers off the bench have committed 3.
And the interesting thing is, Steve, that whole play started when Beckway was not able to finish a shot right at the rim. He had some pressure from the Virginia Cavaliers, but your big guys got to be able to put that shot in the basket.
Add insult to injury. This is the front half of the one-on-one, as that's the eighth team foul on the Maryland Terrapins. And Reynolds gets his first point of the second half. 22 of 30, Maryland is tonight, or Virginia is tonight. Reynolds has missed all four field goal attempts this second half. Reynolds with 15. Virginia stretches their lead to 8 again. Gist down low. Gist put it to the floor, and Kane started to steal. Kane and Deani doing a great job digging it out.
A mistake by Gist to put the ball down with that many people in the neighborhood.
Deani inside for Jamel Tucker. They had him in the post up. Singletary from the foul line.
Now that was some kind of quick move. If he's going to be able to do that, you simply can't guard him. You have to defend that three, and if he goes by like that, you're really in trouble. And Maryland suddenly is really in trouble now. How many opportunities did they have to cut into the lead? They squandered them. Now they find themselves down by 10 again.
Virginia scores back-to-back baskets. Singletary with a couple of free throws. Timeout on the floor as the teams discuss strategy. Well, you should, too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck. Charles Schwab. Right now, Gary Williams is trying to find a way to keep his good players in out of foul trouble and on the floor. And he's got to do that with a rotating floor right now.
Well, I think what he's talking to his team about right now is the importance of getting good opportunities on the offensive end and converting them. Don't think he has any problem with his defense in this half. That zone has been very effective in slowing the Cavaliers down. But the Terrapins have gotten some good opportunities, haven't converted them here recently.
They haven't scored since the 16-20 mark. So it's been over 5 minutes. There's the timeouts left. Gary Williams with only one. Mike Jones to Eric Hayes. Harris Brown looking inside.
And with this lineup in the game, you have to look at Jones and Gist as your primary offensive option.
Harris Brown gets himself inside to carry the ball as he got past the first defender. Turnover number 15. The Terrapins, they'll set up the pressure. Here comes Reynolds. Deani's open for three.
Well, that's a great response by Virginia.
The lead was once four. Actually, it got down to three. And now it's back to 13. 18 points for Deani. And a foul coming up. Foul is on Deani at the other end. A look at the Q Motor Oil Power 25. North Carolina slips to fourth after their loss to Virginia Tech. Duke is in there at 14th. Clemson at 19th from 17th after their first loss. And Virginia Tech debuts in the top 25. Jones from the corner for three. Nice block out. Jason Kane did that. Singletary with a quick three. Kicked around, and it's going to be Maryland ball.
Well, Maryland fortunate to recover that one. Two of their players ran into one. I think it was Parrish Brown and Eric Hayes. Very nearly kicked that ball out of bounds.
The Virginia player already had that taken care of. Amazing. Long shots to get long rebounds, and it almost started the Maryland fast break. Here's a turnover. Kane, up and over. Deani said dunk it, and Kane went for the easy move. And his coach appreciated it. 11 points for Jason Kane, a 15-point lead. For the Virginia Cavaliers, as Gary Williams takes his final timeout with 9:44 left to go in the second half. No pain, no gain. You got that right.
And the Cavaliers have gotten it in gear again. They've forced some turnovers and have been able to get out in transition. Sean Singletary doing a nice job drawing the defense, making the pass. Here's the inside pass as Mikolauskas cuts to the basket.
Nice move by Singletary against the zone. Even against the zone, he does a great job penetrating, drawing the defense, finding the open man inside.
Only the fifth fast break point for Virginia tonight, but had a very timely opportunity. Maryland still scoreless since the 16-20 mark. This drought now is stretching into its seventh quarter.
Steve, it's interesting when they keep stats in a building, they talk about fast break points. The only time they assign a team a fast break point is when somebody makes a layup on the break. But Virginia, if you go back and analyze their game tonight, most of the points they have scored have been in transition situations. It may not be the layup at the end of the fast break, but they've done a great job getting the ball quickly up the court and getting a shot before Maryland can really set its defense.
They really haven't had to do an awful lot of screen and roll and
yes.
set offense tonight. And I think a lot of teams kind of wait for Virginia to do that because they want to see if they can trap Singletary and slow the offense down. And you mentioned it at several junctures in the first half that Virginia does not operate as well out of their set offense in the half court. 6 minutes, 40 seconds since the last Maryland score of any type. Inside of Beckway, playing with four. Gets the basket and the foul.
See, Beckway tantalizes you like that, Steve. That was an impossible shot he just made. But earlier we talked about the one that he had right next to the basket and despite the pressure, it's a shot you expect the big guy to make. That is just some shot right there. You don't expect the big guy to make that one.
Jamil Tucker comes up with a foul. Beckway up for the three-point play, and he wrestles for the rebound. He has worked hard tonight.
Another opportunity for Maryland. Remember, they were down by 20. They hit Virginia with a 13-0 run.
Got three players in the lineup now with four fouls, and Mike Jones gets that basket.
It's really difficult to get any kind of offensive consistency when you're constantly having to take guys out because they're in foul trouble.
Deani to the corner. Deani's down. The energy plug for Virginia tonight.
I said before the game, when Deani is able to produce, Virginia generally plays pretty well. So they've gotten some inside play, and they've gotten play from guys like Deani.
Singletary drains a huge three.
He has something to say to DJ Strawberry again. Strawberry noted as an outstanding defender.
That's three three-pointers.
Jones just couldn't catch it. He was shooting it before he caught it.
73-59, Virginia. 8:38 left to go here in this second half. Gary Williams out of timeouts.
Keep in mind, though, Steve, with this kind of a margin, 8:38 is plenty of time.
Well, Maryland scored 13 points in the space of 3 minutes in the first half. And cut a 20-point lead down to 7 at intermission. Vasquez knocks the ball out of bounds.
Would certainly help the cause for the Terrapins if they could generate some turnovers. But even if they don't generate turnovers, if they can prevent Virginia from scoring in transition, they can play against the set D, get some stops.
Here comes Reynolds for three. And Beckway boards the miss.
Because one thing that Virginia's going to do is continue to play. They're not going to pull the ball out. Try to run time off the clock.
Vasquez for three. Davis Vasquez has his third three-pointer, has 11 for the night. Reynolds with much trepidation. Oh, and a block by Beckway on Tucker. And now a foul coming up on Bowers.
That was a great block by Beckway, but the ball bounced right back into Tucker's hands. A great opportunity for Maryland.
And now Bowers joins the four foul club.
Great block by Beckway, but you see it just bounces right back up to Tucker. A real break for Virginia. Maryland is going to run out of guys.
Yeah. And especially when you consider that they are in a situation where they've got to come from double digits back. So that means they're going to have to take some chances defensively.
That's right, and they've got to play aggressively on the defensive end.
Virginia has missed 9 free throws tonight. Jamil Tucker. With his first 3 three-pointers. Raises this one half 10. His season and his career high is 12. It's a 12-point lead for Virginia. Plenty of time left. Jones into the paint. Here's Bowers. Drops it down to Strawberry. It's turned over. Singletary, 3-on-2. And he's held up by Jones for his fourth foul. court, 7:49 left to play. The fourth foul for Mike Jones. 25 years of bringing you ACC basketball, and we've got a good one here in Charlottesville as Virginia looks to protect its 12-point lead and break a six-game losing streak. Virginia 74-62 over the Maryland Terrapins. 7:49 left to go, and our Chrysler game summary looks like this. Free throws the difference. Virginia outscoring Maryland at the stripe 24-9. Second half field goal percentage, even that's helped Virginia out because they've only shot 35% from the field. And the foul trouble for the Terrapins is big. They've got four players, now five with four fouls. Beckway, Strawberry, Vasquez, Jones, and Bowman. Sean Singletary is the free throw.
And with those kinds of numbers, it's going to be hard if Maryland's down at the end of the game. It's going to be hard to foul to come back in the game.
Singletary makes a pair. He is at 18. He and Deani lead the way. Boston College, a winner tonight. That's five straight at the top of the ACC standings. Vasquez on the move. Is it a block or a charge? It's going to be a block. It's going to be on Singletary, I believe, or is it Deani? It's going to be on Deani. That is two on Mamadou Deani.
You know, with all these guys with four personal fouls, it limits your ability to be aggressive on offense as well, Steve.
Oh, yeah. Vasquez might have gotten away with one. And when you leave free throws on the table like Maryland is doing, they can't ill afford to do that. That's seven misses.
Yeah, now 9-16. In a game where you don't get that many, you've got to make the ones.
12 points for Vasquez.
I think there is some confusion on the part of the official scorer as to the identity of the person who committed that foul. I thought it was Singletary.
And now Ray Natilli is going to come over and talk to you.
And then,
Tony,
you know, the referees, they look at it 44-24, and I think that's, but I really think that was on Singletary, not Deani.
And that Singletary has one. Deani, prior to that foul, had one. So the discussion goes on. Now, is it going to be single? Did they call it on Singletary? They did. They credited to Singletary. Now the question is it going to go back to Deani?
Well, I thought I heard them announce that it was on Deani.
That's what I put in my book.
Well, then, that's what it is, then. They're talking to the coaches. They need to come over here and talk to you.
I'm afraid I can't be trusted for accuracy. Let's see what this.
Vasquez come driving down the lane. And the question is, Deani is right there. Singletary is the guy that he ran into, but did Deani reach in before that? Deani sort of pushed him with that forearm just at the same point. I think what Maryland was like, they have a simultaneous foul called where they get each guy gets a foul. Of course, that's not part of the rules, so that won't happen.
You got to pick one. Ray Natilli is giving the scorers table the result of their discussion. It's 7:41 left to play.
Another at Nate set.
One foul from behind. Told him two on the lane, so we should not have shot the second one. So we got to go to the arrow since we told him two.
Okay.
Well,
we
okay.
Tim Nestor came over and told us.
That's interesting. They gave him two shots when they should not have given them two shots.
Right.
They called that a foul driving to the basket. It was only the eighth team foul and a half. It should have been a 1-1. So they're going to take a point off the board because they should not have given them that. They'll put 8 seconds back on the clock. That is what you call a correctable error.
Gary Williams.
So, but who is the foul?
It's on Mamadou Deani.
Okay, so the foul's on Deani. It should have been a 1-1. Well, now they're saying it's not a shooting foul at all.
And here is Vasquez from the corner, so he makes that academic as he's got 15. 76-65. A three-pointer from Vasquez. Mamadou Deani. Front now goes to Tucker. Maryland now has broken up with a man-to-man and a travel violation on Jameer Tucker. This is how Maryland got themselves back in this game at the end of the first half. With 13 unanswered points. That's 14 turnovers for Virginia. Maryland's at 19. Rebecca moving up and under. Good defense by Kane. Very little room to operate for Rebecca.
We rarely see a play where the officials send a guy to the free throw line to shoot two shots when you shouldn't even have a one-on-one.
And they corrected it, as they should have. Here's Deani for three.
In their defense, the scoreboard did show that it was that Maryland was in bonus.
Yeah. Another offensive rebound for the Cavaliers. Jamel Tucker pulled that one off. This is J.R. Reynolds. Deani active on the baseline. What a play! 20 points! Mamadi Deani, 5 points away from a career high that he got against Arizona. The lead is 13. Strawberry, who has struggled tonight.
Boy, that's really hurt Maryland. Strawberry, only 1 of 7 shooting the ball.
Here's Reynolds on his way in.
Hard for Maryland to be at their most effective offensively if DJ Strawberry is going to struggle. He's their leading scorer.
Strawberry with only 4 points on the line. There's the drive by Strawberry, but it won't count. There was a foul before that. And that foul is going to be credited to Jamel Tucker. And that's his fourth. Hayes and Bowers are in. Jones and Gist come out. Strawberry on the free throw line. And now, Maryland is in one more. We think. Got a timeout taken by Virginia. 30-second timeout at the 5:51 mark. And Strawberry makes the free throw. His first score of any kind in the second half. Virginia now down to 1 timeout. 25 years of bringing you ACC basketball from Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports. We go back into this rivalry. Ralph Sampson's last game at University Hall. On the free throw line against Maryland, he missed the foul shot but gets the rebound. Bang! And it's 83-81 Virginia, March 6, 1983. Our first year. Of course, right up there will be retired numbers is the retired number of Ralph Sampson, number 50. And during the Ralph Sampson era, it's safe to say that Virginia enjoyed unparalleled success as far as postseason tournament is concerned, play is concerned.
At the top of the national rankings during the entire era. One Final Four, an NIT championship.
Strawberry. He has 6 on a pair of free throws. There's only 1 field goal on the night. Maryland, full court pressure, but now by 13. And the ball thrown away by Deani. It's going to be Maryland ball.
Steve, you get the idea that this game is over, that Virginia has the game in the bag, but there's still almost 6 minutes left to go. It's only a 13-point lead.
And it could be 10 right now. Vasquez has his 5th three-pointer of the night. He has 8. He has 14 points. Well, that can't be. Welcome you to Charlottesville, Virginia, where the Virginia Cavaliers have led most of the way against the Maryland Terrapins. 5:32 left to play. Steve Martin here along with Dan Bonner.
Bowers has just fouled out of the game.
He's the first of 5 Maryland players with 4 fouls to walk the plank. He leaves with 3 points.
That's really a tough job for Bowers, even if he didn't have any fouls. But particularly playing with 4 fouls here, those Virginia guards are coming at you full speed because your team wasn't able to make a steal in the backcourt.
Mikolaskis is coming in along with Kane, so that gives you an idea of where Dave Leto wants this game to go here in the last 5.5 minutes. He wants fewer outside shots. Let's take it inside and let's put this thing away. Virginia Cavaliers looking to break a six-game losing streak at the hands of Maryland. Maryland has won seven of the last nine between these two. The last two played here in Charlottesville have been won on the last possession. Mike Jones again, and Eric Hayes goes out. Virginia 27 of 36 from the foul line. Same spot they were victimized in Boston over the weekend. BC went 32-45.
It's just amazing. You look at the numbers for Virginia in their last two games, outscored 26-8 by North Carolina, 35-10 by BC from the free throw line. Today they're dominating from the free throw line.
Blocking foul on Jason Kane will send DJ Strawberry to the line. And DJ Strawberry goes to the stripe. Strawberry, 15.6 points per game. As Dan said, their leading scorer.
Two shots.
Let's not get to see what he's done.
Has only made one field goal in the game tonight.
Strawberry with 7 points on the night. 82-71. These two teams have had some great wins. Virginia's win over Arizona. Maryland's win recently over Clemson. And they've had some interesting losses.
Now, Maryland beat Michigan State in Madison Square Garden. Kane gets the timeout. They beat Illinois on the road at Illinois, but they lost at home to Miami.
Red Lobster presents the nothing but net shot of the game. Mamadi Diani has been nothing but net on the reverse, using the glass. Diani with 20 points so far in this game. Five off a career high. Looks to put together an outstanding sophomore season here at Virginia.
Dave Lato will be the first one to tell you that his offense really needs a third option. You know, generally you're going to be able to count on J.R. Reynolds and Sean Singletary, but when that young man gets it going, Virginia suddenly can put a lot of points up on the board. You know, they've got 82 on the scoreboard. You still got more than 5 minutes left to go in the game. And when teams can score at that point, that pace, it's hard for the opposition to get enough points to beat them.
Jason Kane with a handle to steal Vasquez, but it goes out of bounds. It'll be Virginia ball.
And Maryland in a situation where they have to take risks. You've got to go for those steals.
As you said, plenty of time left, 5:19 to go.
But you have to go for the steals in an intelligent fashion. You just don't go wildly after them. You measure it up, and if you think you have a good chance, you go get it.
Singletary at midcourt. Down underneath the pass. And Velasquez wasn't looking for it. It's a 3-on-2 Maryland break. Jones to score.
That was a tough pass from Mikolauskas. That was a dunk.
18 points for Mike Jones. Diani in the front court. Diani gets underneath. 22 for Mamadi
Diani. Mikolauskas really held off. Gis was trying to get there to block the shot. No chance.
Mikolauskas has some size. You got to go outside of the zip code to get him.
That's a very difficult shot. He was looking for the foul. A bad decision on that one by the young point guard.
Here comes Singletary. Mikolauskas inside the last three. Virginia baskets have been inside. 6 points for Mikolauskas, and Virginia's lead is now 12.
Singletary got him the ball again, but that time Mikolauskas caught the ball right at his chest. One before Singletary threw it below the waist. Well, Mikolauskas nearly gets a steal.
And Strawberry now has to give up the ball without a dribble. Still plenty of time on the shot clock. Vasquez buys a foul. Nobody bought it. They say Vasquez pushed it out of bounds. He couldn't even get credit for Singletary touching it.
And Maryland is not in a situation where they need to panic and do things like this.
Back to live action. Reynolds offensive foul on J.R. Reynolds, and that is three on Reynolds. And that is the 10th team foul on Virginia. So both in the double bonus with 4:07 left to play. In comes Eric Hayes. Out comes Vasquez.
You see, Virginia, even though they have the lead late in the game, they are not pulling back. They're still attacking in the transition. J.R. Reynolds picking up the charge on that play.
Hayes drops it to the post. Here's Gist. Jones for three.
That was a very good inside-outside move by Maryland. Jones just not able to convert. Now, Dave Leto, see, they come down in transition. There's nothing there. Dave Leto calls out an offensive set.
Yanni is the cutter. Reynolds gets the pass out front. Lots of contact. Reynolds may have turned it in.
I'm out. Right there.
Blocks out and heads to the sideline, and that could be a tough call for Virginia, not necessarily in this game as much as what lies ahead of them.
Reynolds has had ankle problems all season long.
Jeff Doyle looks over his injured player. We've got a timeout with 3:33 left in the second half. Virginia leading Maryland by 12.
J.R. Reynolds injures his ankle driving to the basket, and as he goes down the lane, it's his left ankle. Watch right here, and you'll see that left ankle just roll right over. Oh, my. And he has had problems with that ankle throughout the season. Look at it from another ankle. He tries to stop, but just rolls right, that ankle just rolls right over.
He immediately ran off the floor.
Hopped off the floor.
And he gets into the locker room, and Dave Leto hopes he doesn't have to. Joseph gets his first basket of the night. It's 88-74. And Virginia pull away and put this one down for good. Yes, to Jones. Ibeke has Kane on his back and a foul on Jason Kane. Our Pepsi players of the game here in Charlottesville. That's a fourth foul on Kane, by the way. Ikinne Ibeke with a double-double. And Jason Kane as well. 11 points and 14 rebounds. The work done inside by both players. And a big game for Jason Kane in particular, because Dan said he'd kind of fallen out of the rotation. He's now starting his third straight. He started the first game and sat the next week of game.
Well, I talked to Dave Leto earlier in the season about Jason Kane, and he said that he told Jason Kane that he really felt like Kane ought to be scoring 10 or 11 points a game, but he couldn't be doing it by scoring 22 points in one game and no points in the next game, and that was his pattern. You know, in that Arizona game, Jason Kane had 13 points and 12 rebounds, and that was a significant reason why Virginia was able to win that game. And we talked about the importance of an interior contribution, and certainly Virginia has gotten it tonight.
Certainly have, and you almost caught Eric Hayes right in your lap. 3:08 left to go. Virginia by 13. See scores from around the country. Pitt a winner today. Boston College won earlier over Miami. They're 5-0 in
conference. 5-0 in the conference play. Remember, Boston College started the league last year 0-3. They came back and had an excellent season. This year, they decided not to dig a hole for themselves early.
Doing very well at this point. We've got a whistle. Foul coming up. And the foul's going to be on Gist. Strangely, Gist has stayed out of foul trouble.
He's one, as I say, he's one of the few guys that can afford to commit a foul.
That's right. Clock becoming a factor against any Maryland comeback. And J.R. Reynolds is back. And he's going back in the game.
That will make everybody in attendance here happen. When you're a person who's sprained an ankle and who continues to have ankle problems, it's a very scary thing when you roll it over. And anybody who's ever rolled the ankle over knows that there's a tremendous amount of pain right at first. Many times, while the pain is still there, it's not a sprain. You just rolled the ankle and you can come right back.
Tucker comes out. And Mikolauskas comes back in with 2:56 to play.
And once again, building a 15-point lead, that might be more than Maryland can overcome.
Yep. Ibeke to Hayes, back to Ibeke in the post. And Kenny Ibeke continues to build. And there's 13 points. Up in the front foot, Deani.
Oh,
he was met and met hard by Crosby.
Foul.
They met up high.
And then his body took care of the rest.
Now, Osby really swings his arm hard and just keeps the arm coming and brings it down across the chest of Deonte. Really slammed him to the ground. And part of the intentional foul rule is in a fast break situation like that to prevent that kind of excessive contact. But they called it intentional because Osby, after he initially fouled him, just kept that arm coming through and sort of drove him to the ground.
He pulled the arm back. Might have been a different call. With 24 points. And on top of the two foul shots, of course, Virginia maintains possession of the ball. They have a 15-point lead with 2:40 left to play.
Boy, Virginia's gotten contributions from lots of people. You know, Tucker coming off the bench, hitting those three threes.
Real high with 12. Kane having a double-double. This Singletary, and the ball taken right out of its hands by D.J. Strawberry. Strawberry finishes, only his second field goal of the night.
And Strawberry simply has not been able to do that very much. That's what he does best, is slash at the basket.
Singletary, as we run the clock down to the two-minute mark.
Well, Singletary is some ball.
He sure is. Hayes trying to pick up a foul, and Singletary finishes.
He's got five guys in double figures. Singletary's one of them.
And two of 20 plus. Got a blocking foul coming up on Virginia.
You know, I don't care who you are. If the opposition scores 94 points, it's hard for you to get enough to beat them.
Oh, yeah. And Virginia has scored over 100 twice so far this season.
DJ Strawberry. And they scored 108 against Gonzaga.
J. Strawberry makes the free throw. He has 11. And Adrian Joseph checks in, and J.R. Reynolds comes out. Dave Lado says, okay, keep the ankle from blowing up. Maryland goes to Virginia Tech, and that's not going to be easy at all. Virginia Tech is red hot. Then Georgia Tech and all at Florida State in that week. Misses the second. Here comes Kane with a rebound. 2 minutes to play and a steal by DJ Strawberry. They'll take the three and miss. Ibekwe will finish with a dunk. 15 for Ibekwe. 12-point lead, a minute 48 to go. Maryland still pressing. Deonte. Oh, he wanted Tucker to take. Kane says, I'm not a three-point shooter.
Dave Lado says, okay, guys, stop.
Hold this thing out. Get to the showers with a win, which will be their 10th. No timeouts left for Maryland. They can't stop the clock. Deonte off the glass for a new career high. 26 points. Vamani Deonte, 96-82 Virginia. And the celebration will rage on as the spring semester starts. Hayes in traffic, gets the basket. We're under the final minute of play. 8 points for Eric Hayes.
Steve, you showed Maryland's schedule. You showed you Maryland's schedule there before. Going to Virginia Tech is really a tough assignment. Going anywhere in the ACC is a tough assignment as Hayes picks up the foul.
ACC basketball has been brought to you by Bud Light, by your Carolina Jeep dealer, by Alltel, by Food Lion, by Pepsi, and by Geico.
52 seconds left to go. Virginia 96, Maryland 84. You were saying, Dan, going to...
Singletary makes the first free throw, so it's actually 97-84, 98-84. I don't care whether you're playing on the road or home. In this league this year, it seems to me that if you don't play well, you're not going to win.
No.
And Maryland came in here, and they did some things well, but overall, the Terrapins did not play well tonight. Ibekwe picks up the foul. And as a result, they're going to go home with a loss.
Yeah. That's five for Ibekwe, who retires with 15 points. Actually, 17 points and 14 rebounds.
98-86 the score. Virginia is going to break what amounts to 3 years of frustration at the hands of the Maryland Terrapins. They've lost six straight. And they will get their 10th win of the year. They'll go to 2-2 in conference play. Maryland, only their fourth loss overall, however, their third in conference play.
And again, we told you, they're going to Virginia Tech on Sunday, and that is not an easy assignment. And it's, if you fall to 1-4 in the ACC, it's going to be real difficult to dig yourself out of a hole like that.
And of course, Virginia has Wake Forest coming here on Sunday.
You know, Virginia played extremely well, jumping out to that 20-point lead, and even though Maryland threatened them, Virginia never trailed after building that 50-30 lead. Dave Lato has to be very pleased with the way his guys played, particularly in the first half on the defensive end.
Well, definitely. Deani's getting ready to come out. Tucker's coming out with Solomon Tack, and also Will Harris come in. There's Deani with a new career high. 26 points. What a great night for the DeMatha product. 43 seconds left to go. Singletary gets him 1 point shy of the century mark. 23 points for Sean Singletary. That's his eighth game of 20 or more. Now we've got reserves playing the rest of the way. Mike Jones hits the three. And he has 18 points.
Maryland never really able to, you know, they got to that one stretch where they cut it to three, and then they went into a six-minute drought. Virginia finally able to stretch it out.
99-89, here comes Maryland with a run at the end. Paris Brown, which will only affect the final margin, or will it? 26.4, who knows? We got a foul immediately given up here by Brown, and that puts Singletary on the line. And Singletary has been money on the line tonight. Last look 9 for 10, but he may be even more than
that. Sean Singletary, free throw line, and he'll shoot two.
Singletary's high in terms of free throw attempts this year was 16 against Hampton.
Only 4 points now for Sean Singletary.
Disappointed group of Maryland Terrapins.
A tough loss to fathom, a game in which they shot under 42%. Well, they're at 43.7 with some late baskets here. Of course, they're still, they followed their very difficult loss at home, and they only shot 22% against Miami with a win over Clemson. But they could not keep the momentum going. They got a foul coming up on DJ Strawberry, I believe, and he has fouled out. Strawberry fouls out with 17.4 seconds left to go. Virginia crosses the century mark for the third time this season. Strawberry leaves with 11 points, but a lot of those really came after the fact. He was hampered by foul trouble in the first half.
Well, he picked up two fouls early, and he picked up two fouls early trying to guard Sean Singletary. And I that really set the tone for the game. Virginia just came out attacking. They put Maryland back on their heels.
Now, Gary Williams is arguing the clock.
I think he liked the clock
too long.
A little bit faster.
Well, 2 seconds. So he was successful. He was successful in that argument. Tony Green comes away and said, yeah, you got two more seconds.
That's a guy who's just really paying attention to details.
That's right.
You know, I think if that were me, I'd prefer those 2 seconds to be gone. You know, subtract two more seconds.
Let's get to the bus and let's get home.
You know, 17.4. Okay, let's make it 15.4. We got 19.5.
And instead, it is 19.5 for Jason Kane, who goes to the free throw line. 6'10 senior out of Philadelphia. Fine double-double tonight. 12 points. We go with 15 rebounds. Meet us on the Virginia bench as they pick up their second conference win to go with a win over NC State. It seems so long ago. 103-91. Mike Jones. Vasquez, who amazingly hasn't fouled out of this game. Oh, there's a block by Joseph. Eric Hayes tries one. Maryland's going to get some chances, and now it's snuffed out, and it's over finally. John Paul Jones, the arena, the Virginia Cavaliers conquer the Maryland Terrapins, shaking off a six-game losing streak in the hands of Maryland. The final score is Virginia 103, Maryland 91. Sean Singletary, Mamadi Diani, the heroes of the hour for the Virginia Cavaliers.